Yes, Lord.
Have mercy, Lord. Spring out over and bring to me more love abundantly. I've got a new love.
Yes, God.
Flowing out of me. It's the light to walk and the light to see. Open its prison doors, set the captives free. I've got a river of life flowing out of me. I've got a river of life,
yes, God,
flowing out of me. Makes the land to walk and the light to see.
Yes, God.
Opens prison doors, sets the captives free. I've got a river of life flowing out of me. Spring up, always.
Yes, God.
Down in my life, soul.
Oh, What we are tapping into tonight is a secret weapon of the believer.
Yes.
The weapon of tongues. It always paralyzes the enemy.
Yes.
Because he doesn't know what we're saying. It takes the enemy by surprise.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Oh, yeah, you can be seated in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Come on, just keep your tongues going.
Now what's happening in the spirit realm is that you are being filled. You're being filled.
Amen. Thank you.
And depending upon how low your reservoir is, sometimes will determine how long it takes you to kick in gear. So it's just like any other exercise, that the more you do it, the easier it becomes for you. Can you all hear me?
Yes.
Okay, take the ting out for me, Lisa. And so what happens when we pray in the spirit? Remember that we've discovered that my spirit prays. And when my spirit prays, there are mysteries coming from the Lord. There are downloads taking place. That Paul says they are mysteries. They are mysteries. The mysteries of God. The mysteries that you will not always cognitively be able to understand. But your spirit man is being equipped. Your spirit man is being strengthened. And that's the beauty of praying in tongues. We're going to work on this mic just a little bit. I got a lot of ping out here. A lot of ping. It might be some of the things. If y'all can turn us down. Praise God. Those of you. Level lower. Sometimes we get a little ping in the atmosphere because the wind is blowing the sound. Amen. How y'all doing tonight?
Good.
Y'all
great.
Good?
Great.
Good. 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 Okay, see? Praise the Lord. Isn't that good? That's a little bit better. So don't y'all sweat on me, all right? If you do, you run to the door and come right back. I promise not to make you howl and fall out tonight. When we pray in tongues, we're being filled with the Spirit of God. It is an invaluable, invaluable tool that you must begin to use more regularly. And if you have not yet received the baptism in the Holy Spirit, you can receive tonight. Amen. The only requirement is that you believe in Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. That's the real only requirement that there is for you to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. That you are a believer in the Lord Jesus. And once you believe in the Lord Jesus, then all of the beautiful gifts that God has for his people, they now become rightfully yours. But you have to put a demand on it. You have to want it. You have to desire it. You have to know that you need it. And so we picked up the last time that we were together on being filled with the Spirit and living the life of the Spirit-filled believer. Now, what I've discovered is that the reason that we are not Spirit-filled is because we leak every day. Every time you have a situation, when you wake up in the morning, you've been in warfare all night, you just didn't know. Your spirit man has been warring all night because
because the enemy, he is the prince of darkness. And in the night hours, praise God, the Holy Spirit, he maketh intercession. He doesn't sleep. And your spirit man doesn't sleep. So even though you may not be aware of it, if you are alert, you can be aware. I'm aware that my spirit man, it communes with God all night. Sometimes I wake up in tongues. And it's not because I wasn't asleep, but my spirit didn't go to sleep. So you want to build your spirit man up to catch the downloads. You want to build your spirit man up. What we are accustomed to doing is building up our emotions. But we're not building up our spirit. Our spirit is what communes with God. Go to John chapter 4 for just a moment. It's a familiar text, but allow us to just kind of look at it with different eyes. John chapter number 4. And Jesus is there at the well talking to a woman about worship. And that's what we experience tonight, some praise and some worship, because because I don't want you to talk confused. God the Son, Jesus Christ, he talks to this Samaritan woman and he shares a mystery with her. Now, I love this text because it's so rich. It has so much in it. But I want to focus on something tonight that maybe you know, and if you know it, we can revisit it. And if you've never heard it, then praise God, and it will be new information for you. Are you ready? All right, John chapter number 4. And I know that you know all about the water, and praise the Lord for that. But I want you to look down at verse 24. John 4 and 24. John 4 and 24. And when you get there, say, I'm there.
I'm there.
If you're not there, say, I'm on my way. It's already off. So we can do a little ventilation up there. All right, what does this say? John 4 and what, 24? Everybody have it?
Yes.
1, 2, 3, read. What does it say?
God is here.
Yes. Okay, let's read in English. 1, 2, 3, read.
God's the spirit.
Yes. All right. We got some running fast, some running medium, and some running slow. Crack that door, baby. Praise the Lord. Holy Ghost. Got to give the people some air. They're going to fall out. Thank you. All right. So God is spirit. Capital S. Is that right?
Yes.
So what does that mean to you, God is spirit? What does that mean? Talk to me, huh? Okay, can't see him. I don't know if that's true. Not flesh. Great answer. He's not flesh. Because sometimes you can see God. You can see him. He'll allow himself sometimes to have eyes. Sometimes I see an imprint. Sometimes I see different things that I know are manifestations of. But he cannot be, what did we say? What did you say? He's not flesh, which means what? And what else, flesh? What else did we say that flesh meant? All right. So keep going. What did we say flesh was?
He's not
emotional. All right. So flesh is not just the body. Flesh is also emotions and all of that, you know, stuff that we say is the flesh. So God is not emotional. I know y'all think he is. But God is spirit. But also that means he's fluid. He's not concrete. He moves. There's a fluidity to him. So he, you know, in him we live, and in him we move, and in him we have our being.
mean? So God is fluid. God is not here where you think he is by the time you get there. He's moved again because he's spirit. He's always in motion. All right? So that means that to me, if I were going to have to keep up with him, I'm not going to be able to keep up with him in the natural. Because he's fluid. He's spirit. He's moving all the time. God is moving all the time because he's spirit. He's also powerful. You know, spirit is power. Holy Spirit, God is spirit. Holy Spirit, they're operating together. So there is supernatural. So it's not natural. A lot of words can fit right there. God is not natural. That's where a lot of people get in trouble with God. They try to make it natural. But God is supernatural. God is supernatural. He does nothing by any rule book. Does nothing by any law book. He's not even governed by this book. He's spirit. He does what he wants, when he wants, how he wants, just because he wants. Amen. He's spirit. He's sovereign. All right, so God is spirit. Now read the next part of that. God is spirit, and those who worship him must worship in spirit and truth. Now, notice the difference here between God is spirit, which is a capital S, and you and I worship in small s. All right? Talk to me. What do you think that, where are we going with this?
We made his image.
We made in his image, okay. And we're spirit also. All right, we are spirit. What part of us is spirit? The real us. The real us. The real us is spirit, small s. We put a lot of attention to the outer man, but very little attention to the inner man. The inner man is the man of the spirit, our spirit man. Now, how do you worship? In spirit and truth. What does that mean? So, our communion with God must emanate from our human spirit. If I'm going to be intimate with God and worship his intimacy, it doesn't start in my emotions. That's why sometimes when we're in worship, in a deep place of worship, sometimes I can look around and I can see people just kind of wondering what's going on. Because we're accustomed to praise. And praise in it, let everything that have breath praise the Lord. So anybody can praise God. But only those who can tap in to their own spirit can worship God.
Amen.
Because that's his language.
Yes.
That's his fabric. And he created us in his image, which is spirit, so that we can have that intimacy with him, which we now call worship.
Amen.
Now, worship existed long before there was a praise and worship genre of music.